Hello learners, you are welcome to this lecture series where today we shall be discussing on combination of methods used in constructivist learning and teaching process. In this, as we understand, it's a total shift of paradigm from rote memory learning to giving opportunities to the learner to construct his or her knowledge and his or her experiences from day-to-day life. Piaget's theory of constructivist learning has had a wide impact on learning theories and teaching methods in education. Constructivist psychology, which is becoming more popular nowadays, emphasizes that children construct knowledge holistically and learn more effectively when information is embedded with meaningful context. So my emphasis is on context. So what context we are dealing with, in same context we are supposed to learn, we are supposed to construct new knowledge in the classroom processes. Resources and applications, for example, provide opportunity to them to generate new knowledge. Constructivist supports the principle of learning by experience, discovery of observation from day-to-day life, and this is basically a learner-centric approach, where learner is the center of the learning process, where learner's mind, his heart, his day-to-day experiences help the teacher to construct new knowledge in the classroom itself. Students are given enough scope to think critically and construct their own knowledge by linkages with their own surroundings, experiences, both inside the classroom as well as outside the classroom. And thus, this is called constructivist approach. Now, my next point is, the teacher doesn't provide the students with the facts that information and make them memorize them without thinking what they are doing and how they are reaching with consensus or with differences to the content area. Here, teacher plays the role of a facilitator and a mentor who is providing students with a lot of opportunities to construct their own knowledge. This approach helps learners in acquiring problem solving as well as observing critically. This is a paradigm shift, as I suggested in the beginning, which took place around 2004, and thus this constructivist approach has suggested various methods of teaching. For example, there are procedures which teacher follows to make the learning easy and effective. This is objective of all teaching processes in the classroom, to make our learning easy and effective. It is composed of several important steps which are logically and systematically arranged by the teacher. Method is the process, planning, guiding, sharing, and evaluating learning with the group of students. It recognizes the importance of pupils in the teaching learning process, which consider and motivate interest of pupils individually and collectively, collaboratively, where emphasis is given on the constant learning process, which is restructuring with the help of learners' examples. Now, next point is that in order to make teaching learning process more interesting, more effective and meaningful for learners' context, this approach and the methods as suggested in this approach help us devise various techniques of teaching. Teacher doesn't provide students with facts and informations, as I suggested earlier. But here teacher is an himself or herself is helping the learner to be effectively developing their own teaching and learning modules. The prime task of teacher is to create interest and help them actively participating in the process so they can continue learning more outside the classroom as well. When they are going back from school, when they are discussing things outside school, when they are in the family situation. So whatever situation they are working with, they are supposed to be learning and relating it with the context being discussed in the classroom. The characteristic of these teaching learning methods is it matches the mental abilities and needs of the students. It gives emphasis of on students' experiences. It provides scope for peer learning. Now, how it provides scope for peer learning? Like, peers' experiences, peers' context are different from each other. And this mutual discussion in the classroom situation help each one of them to gain new experiences, to enrich their own learning with the experiences of the peers. This method, this approach helps us to learn something by doing. It's not that we just read a book and rote memory is happening or text is going in the printed book or in electronic book, but it is helping them to do something, to try out something. And by this doing, is the learning which is taking place is more effective and long-lasting. It encourages students to think independently and construct their own knowledge. This constructivist approach is going beyond classroom and helping the learner to creatively think. As I suggested earlier, it helps learner to speak out of the context also, out of the situation also, from the personal life experiences also, and from the day-to-day situations also. This provides a scope for development of life skills, which are very important. You must be aware that life skills are becoming core of education sector. WHO has suggested that there are certain life skills which must be inculcated, developed among all the children across the world. So different life situations we need to deal, we need to help. We are supposed to have certain life skills like effective communication, dealing with the working in a group, leadership, etc. This approach is flexible. Instead of following a single method for teaching throughout the period or throughout the text, throughout the chapter, it gives flexibility to the teacher and learner to adopt and adapt various methods which are soothing to the situation. And another aspect is, this is very inexpensive. It doesn't cost much. And there are combination of methods being used in teaching learning process of constructivism. The method used in constructivist teaching and learning process gives emphasis on child-centered teaching learning process. The intention of developing a self-learning modules is to help the learner to solve their issue, to solve their problem, to understand it comprehensively and try to find out a solution on their own, instead of looking forward to the adults around or other sources. A learner by heart tries to resolve his issues, his problems, by looking at the problem in a holistic manner, considering, applying his own mind, and then coming out with his or her own unique solution to the problem. Now, teacher's role is to create situation. A situation where problem can be articulated, proposed, suggested, and students identify the issues related to that problem, and then they try to come up with tentative solutions, tries those solutions, and come out with the best possible solution to the problem. Now, my emphasis is again on best possible solutions to the problem. Lot of methods which cover under this constructivist approach are playway method, project method, problem solving, which is a method of teaching and learning itself, and discovery method, which are some examples which we can always share in a classroom situation. Now, first I will be talking about playway method. All of us, irrespective of our age, enjoy playing. Everybody enjoy playing, one or the other. Nowadays, focus is on playing on electronic devices, computer games, mobile games. But this play, enjoying the sports or actively participating in different games is always very close to the heart of human being. All children love to play. Play is a natural instinct of children now to the adolescent and youth as well. It is a natural expression of their needs. It helps them developing physical, cognitive, social, and emotional growth. But what is the difference between play and work? Is play and work go hand in hand, or these are two different scenarios of human life situation? My point is, maintaining a garden is a work for a gardener, and it's important for his or her livelihood. Whereas, same work becomes a hobby for a young student, young children. It satisfies his or her creative urge, because during the process of gardening, he or she try out various new things, see the life coming out of seeds, applying various fertilizers, watering the plants, decorating it in the fashion he or she wishes to. So it gives a scope to a young learner, young person, or anybody who is not a gardener by profession to be utilizing his or her creative urge. Now, what is the role of a teacher in this method of teaching and learning? The teacher helps the student to initiate games suggested by them, or to develop new games with the involvement of students. Create a learning environment all around that make the children feel that learning is a joyful experience. Here again, emphasis is on joyful learning experience. Playing something means enjoying it. And if I am enjoying it, the whole experience, whether it is giving some learning or not, is a joyful learning experience. Preparing relevant teaching learning material is the responsibility of a teacher, and designing the learning activities. Arranging the learning activities from simple concept to a complex situation. Like whatever we are playing, in a playway mode, we help learner to identify the situation, and gradually we want him or her to move to a little difficult or a complex situation. And this is what playway method has, the strength of playway method. Here, teacher is supposed to be a guide, a supervisor, or a leader who is there for the students during the process of learning, but is not supposed to interfere directly, but is supposed to help the learner, motivate the learner to learn the process on its own. Towards the end of the activity, we are supposed to evaluate students' performance, their interest, to what extent they have been doing it, to what extent they are enjoying it, and what the learning outcomes are there, what they have learned from this activity. Now, it's important to mention here that Montessori method, kindergarten method, and few more activities which are specifically based on this playway method technique. Now, playway method have certain advantages. One is, as I suggested in the beginning, playing is a natural instinct of young people, and participating in it is also helping them spontaneously. Students or learners enjoy the situation because they enjoy more freedom here. They are not restricted, they are not guided, they are not all the time under observation. They don't have any hesitation of being observed, but they are enjoying the game because they are playing, and they are defining their rules on their own with their peers. They can organize the game effectively. Children can create new games. You must have observed that wherever a group of people are playing, group of children is playing, very shortly they devise, they improvise the game into a new set of games. The device, the rule for playing the game, and to observe strictly the self-created discipline which is defined by the children themselves. Now, this helps to nurture the creative skills of children among the development of life skills, where they are feeling motivated to identify a problem and gradually to solve the problem. Within minutes, we can see few children come up to be the leaders. So it is helping them promoting leadership, identifying their own potential. They are arguing among themselves, discussing, debating, and rationality is prevailing in the group, where they are trying to advocate each other about their viewpoint. Their expression becomes important. How they communicate is an effective tool, effective life skill, and At the same time, along with this, they are living a group living, they are learning a group living, and they are learning cooperatively learning. Cooperatively live and let live. So this playway activity helps them. Learning becomes more joyful. It energizes their experiences. It provides sufficient scope to the children to fulfill their physical, emotional, and cognitive needs. And it helps build healthy student-teacher and student-teacher relationships, which is again another important aspect of teaching and learning. Now, there are certain limitations of this method. One is, the method is considered to be more suitable to small children, to pre-primary or primary level students. The content and the concepts of the subjects sometimes feel to be introduced, gradually taken to a theoretical framework. So it can be playway methods are helpful in inducting a method, inducting a new theme, introducing a new theme in a classroom situation, gradually shifting them to a higher academic levels with the discussions, with the active involvement of the classroom. Sometimes few children may give more importance in playing games than learning. Now, this is human nature. We can't stop it. But we must be trying to focus, bring the focus back to the learning and not carry them on enjoying the games only, which is important. Another method which is supported by, which falls under the category of constructivism approach, is project method. A project is an educational method where students working individually or in small groups analyze and develop real life problem or tackle a present day theme within the present time limit, working independently and with the division of task clearly defined. From these definitions, you can observe that a project is a task or an activity. It has some purpose. It is not without purpose. The project always have a broad aim, and that aim gradually help learner to step by step move towards the fulfillment of that project. And along with the fulfillment of the project, along with the active participation in the activity, they learn. It is conducted in social and natural situations. No artificial situations are required. You must have observed, you must have paid attention to the fact that nowadays in teaching learning, this internal assessment in all the disciplines, be it social sciences, be it natural sciences, be it mathematics, projects and internal activities where students can devise their own homework. Teacher can help them identify a situation and to work on it. So this is more into social and natural situation rather than the artificial situation. There are certain characteristics of a project method. One, its situation posed before the students is not dictated by the teacher, but students can always suggest the areas where they want to take up a project. We can relate project with any given situation. If we are going to a village, we are going to an excursion, we are going to a picnic, or we are doing some social survey, we are visiting a mall, any situation we can identify as a project. So, but we need to define the objectives of the project. With what objectives we are getting into this natural and social situation. There we need to help learner identify the clear-cut, broad two or three themes, two or three objectives with which one is supposed to get into the project situation. Now, another important aspect is that project is largely an activity-oriented assignment or a work or a situation. Activity where learner is defining the objective, he or she is creating the learning environment, and students are actively planning the discussion group work. They themselves are defining responsibilities among the group members. And it is reality based. It is necessary to create real life activities for effective learning. Real life activity, I'm not saying an artificial activity, I'm not suggesting something which is far away from the real life situation. So the more real life situation is, the more probability of getting a project inducted. Now, liberty to the participants. This is another important aspect of project method, which allows students to decide themselves freely. Utility is a principle. So project should be useful in their daily life situation. It should be helping them to understand how a situation is handled and how a problem is resolved. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning, that in project method, students are supposed to define their own rules. They are defining the situation. They are themselves defining the responsibilities among the members of the group. So it is giving them a little more democratic space. A platform where students are working together, living together for the situation, deciding each other's responsibilities, respecting the criticism, and giving space to the leaders emerging out of their leadership qualities, with their leadership potential. And democratic spaces are always supported here. Project method is something where students get the scope to imbibe several social qualities like cooperation, teamwork, group affinity, and sacrifices through the group work. It is not me always who is dictating. I may get a contrast opinion from my fellow worker, and there I learn to respect his or her opinion, and I may modify my opinion. I cannot be rigid with my frame of work which I have planned for myself or to the situation. Here I am supposed to listen to the all members and gradually with consensus moving to the situation of activity. But at the same time, there are certain limitations of project method. It is not that project method is indefinite. It do have certain limitations. For example, it is not always possible to employ it in all subject areas of the curriculum. It can be employed where social and natural situations scope. So wherever there is a scope of natural and social situation, there is more possibility of going ahead with the project technique. It is difficult for an average teacher to plan a project. So, teacher need to have a very effective communication skills, effective competencies to identify a project situation, and such situation should be there. There is a lack of proper coordination and inexperience, knowledge acquired through project technique. Problem solving method involves reflective thinking, reasoning, and results from the achievement of certain abilities, skills, and attitudes. You should provide such situations and activities from which problems emerges, and students should be able to identify those problems, those situations. Here we need to define the procedures and where we are confronting with the situation or the problem. We must motivate the learner to find their own solutions. Testing situation. Thus, this method is not only helping the learner to identify a situation and problem, but also help them to be reflective, reasonably understanding the issues of their class as well as of the different classes. Now, I am starting third. I am now moving next to the discovery method, which is again within the framework of constructivist approach. This method is otherwise known as heuristic method. The word heuristic is derived from the Greek word eureusia, eureka, which means to find out. It is also known to be the inquiry method. Now, stages of discovery method are first, identification of a problem, second, experimentation and observation, third, problem solving, fourth, evaluation. After this discovery method, we discuss a problem, define its objective, and student is supposed to discover something under the guidelines or the defined reference of framework where he or she is working. Discovery method develop a scientific and critical attitude among learners. It fosters the art of testing patiently, observing keenly, and conducting experiments neatly, cleanly, and responsibly. It develops self-control, self-confidence, self-reliance, and self-determination. This method provides enough training to prepare them for life. Here, the students learn facts through their own behavior. Learning becomes more effective and permanent where they are enjoying the situation. But again, this method do have certain limitations. For example, all students may not participate in the teaching learning situation. Very few of them would be actively participating in this situation. Sometimes students are stopped from questioning. Sometimes students would need some reference material. So teacher has to ensure to provide that reference material which is required for the discovery of the event, for the discovery of the situation. Sometimes student would need some other apparatus, equipments to conduct an experiment. Sometimes the students may not formulate hypotheses relating to the problem. So this is about the constructivist approach, which help us constructing new knowledge in any given situation. So today's lesson is about constructivism and various methods supporting the constructivist approach. We discussed project method, we discussed discovery method, we discussed problem solving method. Thank you. We'll meet again with the next unit in the same series. Thank you. Bye-bye.